ancient form of treating wounds is making a comeback in South Louisiana, saving thousands from amputation.
The Romans used them. They are nature's way of cleaning wounds.
One Northshore hospital is using sterile medical maggots to treat people who are at risk of losing their foot, leg, or other limb, and it says it's seeing some success.
WDSU anchor Randy Russo tells us how these so-called tiny surgeons are helping patients who otherwise had no hope.
In just a matter of months, Beth Dubois had her life turned inside out, learning she not only had diabetes, but that she may lose her foot.
It was just dry skin, and I scratched it, and then it, you know, got raw, and I put antibiotics on it, but it didn't do anything.
The diabetes had prevented Dubois from feeling her lower leg, causing the sore to get worse and worse to the point of amputation. But now an old form of medicine is giving her new hope. Medical maggots.
I knew it was an old treatment that they used long, long ago, and I wasn't turned off. I was anything besides a knife was wonderful, you know.
After a month of treatment at Northshore Specialty Hospital, her wound significantly improved. Sterile medical maggots remove only the dead tissue, leaving the viable tissue for doctors.
Nature oftentimes does things better than we do in medical science. And nature has perfected these little tiny surgeons that will remove tissue better than any surgeon on the planet because they know what's healthy and living and they know what's dead.
Dr. Sean Carpenter says he's seen great success from the use of these little creatures and has been able to save the limbs of thousands of patients who had once been told there was no other choice.
Oftentimes they've had the wound for years or they've been told, look, you just need to get this wound taken care of by an amputation. If we get rid of the leg, you have no more wound, no more problem. But then, of course, that leads to all sorts of other problems.
In diabetes patients, Carpenter says studies show the more amputations, the more likely a person will die sooner. And Louisiana has the second highest diabetes mortality rate in the country. Because of the nerve damage from diabetes, Carpenter says many patients don't even feel the medical maggots at work. And once they're done, it makes his job much easier.
It's almost like unwrapping a Christmas present because when you take those maggots off, what's left underneath that dressing is a beautifully clean wound.
Carpenter will follow this treatment up with others like hyperbaric therapy using platelet-enriched plasma and debridement therapy, which is also working on other patients like Kim Martin, who has sores on her leg from sickle cell.
I haven't been able to put my feet in regular whole shoes in about 4 years, and I can put my foot in a shoe now.
While Dubois has a long road ahead, she has hope that she can continue the journey with both feet.
Losing a limb is forever. If there's any chance that you have to saving your limb, you need to find a good wound care facility, and I'm thankful that I have.
On your side, I'm Randy Russo, WDSU News.
Northshore Specialty Hospital also just launched its new hyperbaric therapy unit for its limb salvage program. In addition to diabetes patients, this kind of treatment can save the limbs of people with flesh-eating bacteria and other serious injuries.